Hello everyone, my name is Maartje from Crafty Crow Designs. In a previous video I showed several techniques with which you can use hot foil without having to use a hot foil machine. If you haven't seen that video yet, I encourage you to check it out. I will also link to it in this video. In the card I am making today, I am also using some hot foil techniques. First, let's get started with the stenciling. I am using the plaid stencil from Lanvin on Guava cardstock. When I do ink blending, I always use my Tailored Expressions blender brushes, which are my favorite. And I am using the new Distress Oxide Villainous Potion. It is really interesting to see the effect of the Villainous Potion in combination with this cardstock. So at the moment the Guava cardstock still looks sort of pink, but when I am done with the stenciling, it has more of a reddish look to it. As this stencil is quite dainty, I am being quite careful when I do the ink blending. So I try to make sure that those lines, they do not move when I am doing the ink blending. So sometimes you also see me holding those lines down a bit. If you have some temporary spray adhesive, it would be perfect to use with this stencil to keep it in place. But I don't have it, so I just do it like this. So now I am done with the first two layers of the stenciling, and now it is time to use the second stencil to apply some thinner lines over top, and with this one I am going to use hot foil gel. With a spatula I am going to apply the hot foil gel over the stencil, and I am making sure that there is only a very thin coat on top. And at the moment the hot foil gel is white, and when it turns clear then it means it is ready to use and then you can start to do some foiling with it. With me it took about 45 minutes before the hot foil gel turned clear, so you do need to think ahead of time. After this first layer turned clear, I also turned the stencil again 90 degrees to also apply another round of the hot foil gel, but I did the same process so I will not show it in the video. As the gel has turned clear now, it is time to do some foiling. The foil I am using is from Spellbinders and it is the Glimmer Hot Foil in the color Champagne. I am putting my background with the foil in a carrier sheet and I will feed this through my laminator. In the hot foil technique video I talked about earlier, I talk more in depth about foiling with a laminator and also without. So if you want to know more and also get some tips, then I suggest you watch that video. Now my background has run through the laminator, so I can do the big reveal. I really love how well this hot foil gel works, and because you are working with a gel, you also have sort of a raised edge where you have applied that foil. So it is a bit of a different result than when you work with a hot foil machine. But if you want to try out foiling before you buy a hot foil machine, then this is quite a good inexpensive way to try it out. Also for the sentiment on this card I am going to do some foiling. So there will be quite a lot of foil on this card, so it's not exactly subtle. For the sentiment I'm going to do something I like to call hot foil pouncing. So I put some of the hot foil gel on an acrylic block and with my blending foam I'm just picking it up and slightly pouncing it on top of the sentiment. It is quite hard to see in the video, but with this technique you do get some sort of texture. So the foiling result will also not be perfectly smooth. The process of foiling for the sentiment and the background is exactly the same. So I trim down a piece of foil, also in the champagne color, and I am putting it together with my background in my carrier sheet. Then I just need to feed it through my laminator, and the pressure and the heat will help the foil stick to the hot foil gel. As I mentioned before, this bouncing technique does create texture with the hot foil gel, so the foiling is also not perfect, but it sort of has a distressed look. But I don't mind this at all, I think it looks kind of cool. So now the elements for the background and the sentiment are done, so we can do some Copic coloring. I stamped these images from Snow Friends from Mama Elephant on perfect coloring paper with Memento Tuxedo Black ink. I'm going to keep the coloring of these images very simple and I try to match the colors with the colors of the background. When I get started on the coloring of the actual snowman, you will see that I'm going quite dark. But in the end, the snowman still looks light because the background is dark, so just pay attention to it later on. Throughout the coloring, I am also putting down the caps of the Copic markers I am using. Now for the rest of the coloring, I will just put up some music so you can enjoy the music and watch me color. See you in a bit! Alright, that was all the coloring. Now before we will start with assembling the card, I first wanted to do one last thing with the sentiment. At the moment the gold sentiment is not really standing out that much from the background, so what I'm going to do is adhere my gold sentiment on white and I'm also going to offset it a bit. This will not only help with making it stand out from the background, but it also will add some white to my card, so it will match better with also the critters that I colored, because they are also white and have a white border. So now that I have finished off the sentiment, I can also go ahead and adhere it down. And then next to the sentiment, I will adhere my critters. For adhering the critters, I am going to use foam squares from scrapbook adhesives. And I'm going to use the regular ones and also the thin ones to create some variation in dimension. For the two snowmen, I am using the regular foam squares. And then for the dog, I am using thin foam squares. When I adhere things down with foam squares, I always like to add some liquid glue, because that helps with allowing some wiggle room. If you do not put on the liquid glue, then you basically get one shot with the foam squares to adhere it in the exact place you want. And with the liquid glue, you can still see and move it a little bit until you are happy. And then here is the finished card. So as you can see, it is quite a lot of foil, so it is a bit in your face and not really subtle. But I hope that you also learned something with the different techniques that I have applied. If you enjoyed watching this video and you found it helpful, please remember to give it a thumbs up and also subscribe down below. Thank you so much for watching and see you next time.